Good afternoon, I think it is now, everyone, and thank you very much indeed. Thank you, Martin. But I am also delighted that Enda Kenny decided that we would have a ministry, a full ministry for children at cabinet level. And I think that probably of any group I could be speaking to today, that no group would appreciate more the importance of that decision to have a full minister at cabinet level responsible for children and youth affairs. I want to thank you for the invitation to be here today. This is the first County Childcare Committee event, actually, that I've been at since I was made a minister. So it's a particular pleasure to come into the room and see so many people here. And I do want to acknowledge, of course, as has already been done, the presence of Deputy McConaghlogue and congratulate him on his election. And I look forward to working with him in the Dáil on the issues that concern all of us in this room. And I'd also like to thank Councillor Desi Larkin for his kind words about my appointment. It's very important that there is cross-party support on this issue, because really there is no more important resource in this country than our children. There was some what I called inappropriate comments about the fact that women were responsible in the cabinet for protection and for children. In fact, I consider those two ministries absolutely critical and essential to the future of this country, and as critical and important as every other ministry around the table. And I know as people working in the sector that you will agree with me on that. We all face a huge challenge, particularly in tough economic times, to ensure that we have the best possible environment for that precious resource of over 1 million children. And it is a statement of value by the government, by the Taoiseach, by the parties in government to create a full ministry. It's a strong statement of value about what is important and what is essential in our society, and about what we need to protect, and about the quality of services that we need to deliver to young people and children, very young children, in this country. I suppose over 20 years ago, when I first began working on issues in relation to childcare, and when I was chair of the National Women's Council, you wouldn't have walked into a room with this number of people involved in the childcare sector. And there has been, and it is wonderful to see, the most extraordinary progress in this sector and in relation to providing services for children. And while there's a lot of focus on the economic situation and the challenges, and I was thinking about this as I sat listening and watching the children, in some ways we do live in a kind of parallel universe about children. Because on the one hand, we see the extraordinary progress that's being made and which is exemplified by the conference here today and by your work. And then on the other hand, we hear about, and I will be receiving in the next few months, a whole series of reports outlining, and we've already had many of them, outlining the very serious difficulties and situations that many children have faced in our country. So we do have that kind of parallel situation of extraordinarily challenging and disturbing reports which have emerged and will continue to emerge about the experience of many children in the country. And on the other hand, we live in a more sophisticated age where just this week I attended a conference with 300 young people between the ages of 14 and 18 on mental health issues at a conference called My Mind Matters. It wouldn't have happened 10 years ago. You wouldn't have had young people at a conference talking about mental health and being willing to discuss it and discuss how they can help their friends and peers and how their schools can help people who are experiencing mental health difficulties. So there is this wonderful development and insight and understanding, and I suppose exemplified by a lot of what Dr. Tony Humphreys had to say earlier. And I'm sorry I missed out on that therapy. You can always do it a bit more therapy in politics and more advice. I just caught the last few minutes of it. But, you know, we have this parallel world. And I suppose my job as Minister for Children is to ensure that all children have the very best experiences, that we continue to give the kind of support that has been given to childcare at a very difficult economic time, to ensure we have the kind of development that you have seen here in Donegal, which has been quite extraordinary. I want to thank Avril for the work that she's doing. And when I looked at the brochure which she spoke from this morning, where she talked about then and now, it is quite extraordinary. And I know that you in the sector will acknowledge the roadmap that we've come from and how significant it has been when you see the quality of buildings that were available, when you see what's available now, when you see the numbers in the sector compared to the numbers that were there, when you see the kind of work that's been done with the children, as we've just seen, and when I read about and in my brief see the kind of training that the Child Care Committee have been involved in. So all of that, I mean, it is a celebration that you have invited me here today to, and it's always good to be invited to a celebration and a recognition of work that has been done. And I know you will be presenting some awards to particular people and services later in the evening as well. And it is really critical to celebrate what we have achieved while being very mindful of what needs to be done and the challenges that are out there. And I recognise the challenges, particularly in the current context. And what I want to say to you is that as Minister for Children, I want to hear about those challenges that you're facing on the ground. I will listen to them. I will do my very best at cabinet level to ensure that you get the kind of support and the resources that you need to do the kind of quality work that is necessary to deliver and to develop in the sector. And I want to thank you for your support in developing the ECCE programme, which is so successful now. And there are issues, and I know what the issues are. Today isn't the day for me to particularly address them, but I want to assure you that I appreciate some of the problems in relation to the scheme. But I also want to point to the very high success rate, the fact that now over 90% of our young three-year-olds have access to high-quality daycare services all around the country. That is a major achievement. And thank you so much for your work in relation to that. Thank the committee for their support of my department's work in establishing that committee. So there are a huge number of areas where there is expansion, where there is great support, where there is development, all of which bodes very well for the kind of services that we want to deliver to our young people in the years ahead. So I will conclude by saying that I want to acknowledge, and I am acknowledging by my presence here today, the work of your Donegal County Child Care Committee, of all of you in the sector. It's a recognition of the work you have done, of the challenges that remain, and of my support for you. I want to thank you for inviting me here today. It's a real pleasure to see the kind of programme, the conference programme, your third annual conference, to see the type of programme that you've put together. I'm delighted that Gordon Jays was here to speak earlier. It's a wonderful appointment, and he is already changing much of what was a problem within some of the service delivery. It's easy to criticise what doesn't work, but there is huge effort made by individual practitioners all the time. As a social worker who worked in Dublin and London, who worked in the inner city, who's worked with children and families, who's trained as a therapist, I recognise the work of individual practitioners. But I know we do not get our service delivery right sometimes, and I know that bureaucratic issues can interfere with the service delivery. And what's really important, and it's part of the message of this government, that reform is important, how we deliver services is important. We must not let bureaucratic structures or the organisations with whom we work interfere with the delivery of services rather than support that delivery. So that's my message to you today. I want to thank you for the work that you're involved in. Can I wish you every success and reassure you of my commitment to the value of the work that you do, my commitment to ensuring that it develops and progresses as much in the years ahead as it has done in the last 10 years. Thank you very much indeed.